nor comest thou yet, my slothful love, nor yet, Leander, oh, my Leander, canst thou forget thy hero, Leander, why dost thou stay, who holds thee cruel, what hath begot thee? Fevered morn will chase the darks of night. Ah, me, I burn and die in these my languishing desires. See the table waste in his own fires like me. Before you come, make haste then, my Leander, prithee come. Behold the winds and seas, deaf and enraged, my imprecations have in part assuaged. Their furies pass, let thou more deaf than they, merciless, torment me with delay. Far from hence, upon thy native shore, such hiding life thou takest, waitest thou more inside my heart desires, with faithless lines, flattering me with promise, that when the winds became less high, at some repose, if I did but the friendly torch expose to be thy guide, thou wouldst not fail to come. The shores of peace. Transport the hero. unto the shore. Now with hasty hand doth fling his rope from him, and even now bold boy attempt to swim, parting the swelling waves with ivory arms. On a balloon, my love, all powerful charms. You gentle, peaceful winds, if ever love had part in you, if ever you did prove this spark of Cupid's flame, for pity's sake, with softer gales more smooth and easy, make the troubled floods unto my soul's delight. You showers, you storms, and tempest blurs night, retire your fury till my love appear, and bless his shores in safety. Shade by her faint light, something methinks I spy, resembling my soul's joy. This light.